I wish I knew how to blur out my license plate. I wonder if it even matters. Whatever, I'll just post the video anyway. Wait, before you post that, it's actually very simple to blur out personal objects in a video. Let me show you how it's done in Adobe Premiere Pro. Okay, let's break this down as simple and easy as we can. Masking and blurring out personal objects in a video is very important and it's also very easy. Here's a clip of me getting out of my car and we can tell that the license plate is easily legible. So let's break down how to blur that out. So the first thing we're going to do is add a Gaussian blur and just drag that right onto our clip. And then we are going to create a mask with this blur. So I'm gonna do a 4-point mask just to start this off with, and I'm going to drag it over the license plate. And we don't wanna overdo this and make it just completely unnecessarily blurry like this. A pro tip when applying a mask like this is to make it look unnoticeable. You don't want the viewer to recognize that it's even there. Another thing we can do to help it blend into our video more is to just add some mask feather. This is going to make it very difficult for the viewer to understand where the mask starts and where the mask ends. So now let's just drag this mask over the four corners of our license plate until it's no longer visible. And since we added the feather, we just need to make our mask a little bit larger than the license plate. Perfect, now let's watch this back. That looks great. Now this shot was nice and easy. Our license plate was staying stationary, but what if we had a moving object in the video that we want to blur out? Let's break it down. So here we have a shot of me sitting down on a bench and a stranger walks past in the background, AKA my videographer, Nate, and we're gonna try to blur out his face. So let's start back from the beginning. We're gonna drag our Gaussian blur. This time I'm going to use the eclipse mask because it matches his head more. So we'll just drag that down, make it a little bit smaller and put it right over his head. And then bump up the blurriness to, again, a natural amount. We don't want to make it overboard and just make it look ridiculous like that. We want to keep it natural and just enough to where we can't notice who this person is anymore. So this is the fun part. We have our mask over our stranger's face. And when we click play, he just walks right out of the mask and the mask stays right there in the beginning. But if we want to track his face all the way across this frame, then all we need to do is come up to mask path and click track selected mask forward. And this is going to create keyframes that are going to track his face in the mask across the whole video. So now if we just scroll back and forth in our timeline, we can see that the mask now tracks Nate's face perfectly across the whole frame. It's important to take personal information seriously with video, no matter what skill level you are. Most people don't fully understand that once a video is posted, there is no getting it back. So take the extra step to protect yourself by trying this out in Adobe Premiere Pro for yourself. I'll see you in the next one.
Wow, I guess I didn't know it would be so easy. I'll definitely do that before I post this video. Thanks, Adobe Premiere Pro.